Tibet, a country bordered by the gigantic walls of the Himalayas, the highest peaks in the world, Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, K2, cut only by a few icy, windswept passes. Tibet, a forbidden land, surrounded by vast, unexplored territories. And in Tibet, Lhasa, the city of golden roofs. A few authentic reports about Tibet, a country divorced from the world we know. For centuries, it has gone its own way, remote and secret. Now, even the sparse reports have stopped completely. Ours is the last to come before the curtain finally closed. A report which reached us by a strange and a roundabout route. By mule over the mountain passes to India. There was no other way and no other transport. For in Tibet, the use of the wheel as a means of transport is prohibited. The wheel is only a symbol. It represents the wheel of life. They went far from even a caravan route. They never knew where the dog had come from, which followed them with strange faith. Like themselves, it was a wanderer. For these two men, the journey became their whole life. They had nothing now except their freedom. And yet, ironically, they were surrounded by riches. Oil bubbled up through the stones and just burned away. They were in a land where such wealth has no value. And for them, too, it was useless. The treasure for which so many men have fought and died, gold, lay untouched in the stream. But they had been forced back to the simplest thing. And the stream held only one wealth for them. They learned ancient skills and new pleasures. With wild onions growing on the mountain slopes and the trout in the stream, they had no thoughts for the gold and the wasting oil.
For 2 years through these mountains and these valleys, with before us one goal, to get to Lhasa. More and more we met upon the way. At last we knew we were on the great road which leads to Lhasa. We came down through the mist and we saw that the mountains lay behind us. This was the sacred road, the pilgrim's way to the holy city, and the merchant's route to the center of all things. The yak caravans moved slowly towards Lhasa. Nowhere wheel, nowhere cart or carriage, just the steady plod of animals. We met the nomad families who live on the high plateau. 12,000 feet up, they wander with their herds, pitching their tents for months or two, and then moving on again when the animals have stripped the pasture. Whenever we arrived at a camp, they would greet us with cups of yak butter tea. We were used to the rancid taste and the flavor from the fires of yak dung, their only fuel. With every mile as we approached Lhasa, the road became a little easier for us, smoothed by the pilgrims who have gone this way for more than 1,000 years. We met caravans of yaks laden with bamboos from India, the great bamboos which carry the prayer flags on which they write their prayers. O Mani Padme Hum. O Mani Padme Hum. The prayers which the wind shall carry over the mountain. Everywhere, there were signs of a deeply held faith. Only here is the wheel which carries their prayers.